forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things for which we are not worthy to ask, except through the merit of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Answers as I pray unto you.
Thank you.
Hear God's most of our lives are filled with non-stop soundbites. Some of us are uncomfortable with even momentary spaces between sounds. We feel the need to say something, to fill the void, afraid of what a silent time might bring us. There seem to be less and less opportunities for us to take a sound break, to listen to our hearts, to listen to God. We rush to make a decision, find an answer, and move on to the next thing. Do we steer clear of opportunities to reflect and take time to let God speak to us? When we are afraid or desperate for an answer, we may be tempted to jump at the first voice we hear. The one who yells the loudest seems to have the most power, promises a quick remedy to our situation. The one who may just be offering a false hope. Through Elijah, God reminds us that God will find us if we only allow the space. Sometimes we need to stick around into the wind and the earthquake and the fire. Stick around to get to the silence and hear that still voice. A voice that comforts and calms our fears. The voice that assures us that we are not alone. But God will make sure of that. God comes to us in a variety of ways. And to some, God may appear in the midst of the noise. But for most of us, it is not that exciting, not the stuff of Hollywood, and we may get a little discouraged. We too may think we're alone. We may feel an absence of God's presence. There may even be days when we come to church feeling that God is missing in action. We miss God in all the noise that surrounds us. We may get discouraged and look for reasons why we are unable hear God speak to us in the readings, the music, or the preaching. It is in these times that we need to remember that God may be looking for a smaller, less flashy, more silent way of connecting us today. It may be that this day the music is unfamiliar, the reading seems to distance, and the sermon seems to miss the mark. These days happen to all of us. That doesn't mean that God is not present. We know that God speaks to us through the scripture and the music and the word, and God speaks between the scripture and the music and the word. Sometimes we need to take a break from the sights and sounds that surround us continually. Elijah had gone off to the desert to escape the real world and his troubles. He was able to have some alone time to meditate and reflect on the events that had occurred to gain some perspective. It was after this time of reflection that God sent a messenger to him and invited him into his presence. God came to Elijah when he was feeling alone, feeling like a failure, ready to give it all up. God came to lift him. Encourage him and save him. God came to him in the midst of his darkest days. Matthew's gospel tells the story of Jesus coming to the disciples when they too are afraid. They were to go without him, and the wind is tossing them about. Suddenly they see a figure walking towards them on the water. Oh no, what now? It's a ghost, they shout in terror. Jesus calmed their fear and spoke to them in love. It is me. Be not afraid. Jesus, our Lord and Savior, spoke to them when they were reached out a hand to help Peter when he stumbled on the sea. Answered the plea, Lord, save me. Many Christians take yearly retreats to escape from the noise and distraction of their everyday lives. They seek a silent place in which to come into God's presence. For others, yearly retreats lasting even a day or two taking even a few hours away from others or without noise or distraction would be too stressful. Each of us has a different way that we keep the press within us, a different way to seek comfort and healing. Unfortunately for many of us, it is when we avoid opportunities for a bit of quiet time that we risk getting overwhelmed. We risk losing touch with our thoughts, our feelings, and our hearts. We also risk losing touch with God. We risk blocking God out with too many competing voices. We may think we don't have enough time to spend a few minutes disconnected, a few minutes in silence. For the thousands that take the chance to experience a retreat or even a few moments in meditation or silence, they report being changed forever. They experience a calm and peace that had been elusive to them before. They get to take a breath. They put things into perspective, see things clearly for maybe the first time ever, for the first time in a very long time. One of my favorite verses for quiet reflection is found in Psalm 46, verse 10. Still and know that I am God. A helpful exercise for me when I'm experiencing information overload or feeling far from God is to repeat the verse over several times, pausing after each repetition, and then starting with the word God, leaving off one more word until all that is left. Like a grown-up version of bingo. I invite you to take a moment with me and give it a try. Take a deep breath and close your eyes. Just listen or repeat the words with me. Be still and know. Still, I know that I am. Be still, I know that I.
Be still,
I know that I. Be still, and know. Turning out life's distractions can remind us that God is always present, always ready to just be with us. God came to Elijah in his hour of need, his lowest point, but all seemed God came in that still, small voice. Jesus came for the disciples in their hour of distress. He came towards them and lovingly calmed their fear. He parted his eye and said, "Do not be afraid." We all have times when we are at our wit's end, lost and alone as Elijah, seeking an answer from God. Or maybe times when we venture into the unknown, we try to do the impossible only to realize that I can't do this alone. I need help. I need my Savior. Jesus comes as our Lord to take our hand, help us through the storm, through the waves, calming our fears. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we know that there will be times when we hear you speaking to us in the music and the scripture and the words proclaimed. And then there will be times that we hear your voice between the lines in more subtle and silent ways. Inspire and empower us to be bold to say, "Lord, save me," at those times when we find it hard to hear your voice. continue to seek us out when we hide in our caves, when we stand on the mountaintop, and every place in between. Break through the noise and distraction that keep us from you, and remind us to be still and know that you are God.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of peace and justice, you call us to live as your beloved community throughout the world. Instilled in local, regional, national, and global political and civic leaders, a desire to work for the well-being of all people. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is greater.
God of care and compassion, you bring assurance when we are afraid. Bring calm to any who are anxious or fearful. Bless the work of therapists, nurses, and other health care providers. Comfort all who grieve and soothe any who are sick, especially Nancy, Annie, Mark, Alex, Peter, Wayne, Diana, and Melissa, Jennifer, Denise, Gladys, Artie, the Saintman family, Judy, Peter, Kimberly, Cindy, and Michael, Gloria, Sybil, Mike, Christopher, Kaylee, and Sam, Judy and Andrew, Deb, Pastor Rebecca, John, Martha, and those we name silently or aloud. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of wonder, you accompany us in both joys and sorrows. We pray for children and teachers preparing for a new school year. Make your presence known in our work and our play, in lively conversation and in quiet rest. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of new life, you send people to renew both church and society. We give you thanks for their lives of faithful service as examples of following your call. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray. In the name of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Also with you.
Peace, Molly. Thank you.
and will do to give thanks in the right place, so little where I played it before.
Because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. And the Lord has done for me. Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. If I am strong, let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. If I
let's join together in the offering prayer. Let us pray.
God, heal the forest, see the sky, Lord, hear all good things. Sustain us with these gifts of your creation, and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection, open to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, 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 Lord, our power and heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
Holy God, our Maker, Redeemer, and Healer, in the harmonious world of your creation, the plants and animals, seeds and stars, were whole and well in your praise. When sin had scarred the world, you sent your Son to heal our ills and to form us again into one. In the night in which you prayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. And after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Remembering, therefore, his acts of healing, his body given up, and his victory over death, we await that day when all the peoples of the earth will come to the river to enjoy the tree of life. Send your Spirit upon us in this meal. As grains scattered on the hillside become one bread, so let your church be gathered from the ends of the earth, that all may be fed with the bread of life, your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, and the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, now and forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one, let us pray.
Our Father,
be seated and come forward, beginning on my right, to receive the bread to dip into the chalice. If you'd like a pre-filled communion, you can come on the table.
Thank you. with Christ is for you.
Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one who is our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Be seated for a minute. Please join us at the worship down the hallway in the fellowship room. It is an air conditioned and there's lots of food. The Protestant Collaborative will be sending out some notices tomorrow about our fall worship plan. So please check your email and your mail tomorrow and the next day. And continue to do so as we will be having more announcements come out. And we want to make sure that everyone is informed. Joseph Scarhausen Closet is still looking for items. They're listed here in the bulletin. Please speak to Kathy Bettinger if you have questions on what items they may take or may not take. Our beach Bible study continues until the end of August at Summit Meadow. Please join us for that. Backpacks and school supplies. We're getting a nice collection, but we could still use more. So please bring in some school supplies. If you're somewhere to see them on sale, please grab some items and bring them in. They go to the children's shelter. The preschool at St. Peter's is that time of year. They're registering and they are also looking for substitutes. So if you like working with little kids, I'm not sure exactly what the qualifications have to be, but look into give them a call to see if they need your help. Are there any, choir members, please stay after to reimburse the choir anthem from the last week.
That's right. 27th, we have a
wait a minute before you can go get your poultry.
It's a fairly short campaign, so you can get back for the food because there'll be a line anyway, so.
Quick front group, so please, you want to join singing on the last week of August, then please stay for a few minutes. Are there any other announcements? Please rise as you're able. The God who calls across the cosmos and speaks in the smallest sea, bless, keep, and sustain you now and to the end of the age.
Amen.
Peace and share the harvest.
Thanks be to God.